Alright, good evening viewers. Today we tonight we've got some DX coming in. So I'll just extend my little cutoff area. So we've got a shortwave station. And the first camera that is going to interfere with it. The frequency is 9830 kHz. Well, this is a proof that shortwave is dead. It's primarily most of the parts that have shortwave I can't receive because I'm too far away or a little crappy little antenna. In fact, it's supposed to go twice as long, but it broke. And that doesn't. But this is direct from China. This is not SPS. SPS is,
Có thể mỗi chúng ta đều mơ ước tương lai. Mình được làm công việc mà buổi sáng thức dậy.
SPS is the station that's done in Australia for people who can't speak English. Like my grandparents do it for now. They basically just do the current news, you know, the specific language for 1 hour. Like, I have notifications on my phone saying when language is up because I only learn language. The best way is just submerge yourself in it and pretend you know everything. Like mine, I have notifications that SBS2 is being now broadcast in Russian. Why Russian? I don't know. Because I can. But this is not SBS, this is direct from China. This is China Radio 1 or something like that. Now, SBS is not coming in loud because the aerial is bad. Just annihilate that thing. Also, the light will, the light interfere with it. Oi, there we go. We got more. Alright, so that is shortwave reception from China. I guess that's it. Shortwave is not bad. And especially in a global emergency, which is pretty much going to happen, maybe going to happen almost tomorrow, with the way North Korea is going. It's good to have only shortwave radio sitting around. Even better, a vowel-based one. Why vowels? Well, if there's an EMP, this thing will die. It won't work, because it's micro-control-based. Vowels are not. They can take voltage transients. That's why, if you do anything with TV repair, you will know on the old vowel-based set, you can ask to fly back, the high voltage and all that. And if transistor shot, don't even bother, you'll destroy it. You'll destroy it more than the whole output transistor. You'll destroy literally everything else in it. The valves, no, it's not going to happen. You can ask them all day long. They'll take it. They'll take the hit. So you should always have one of these, you know, in the go bag when something goes wrong. Or AM transistor radio. This is air band, you know, FM, medium wave, short wave, long wave, and air band. It's excessive, but you know, why not? This will be destroyed. I've got a little pocket transistor AM radio kicking around, so that will be used in emergencies. But then it comes to like bad things where short wave will come in handy, and I will try and buy myself a Zenith transistor. You know, or just something of the like, or just buy a little valve AM radio and convert it on a shortwave using double conversion. But that's about it. So yeah, that is China Radio 1 coming in on little crappy shortwave J-Card radio in Melbourne, Australia. Hope you enjoyed.